$3.99 in the App Store. It's called #1 Steel Pan App Gold. And the other one is called Steel Pan 3D. Okay? So take some time and download those apps on your cell phones or on your tablets. And then we will get started now. So we have three main goals today. The first one, so by the end of this session, you will be able to, one, outline the sequence in the development of this instrument, two, identify different types of steel pans and the music it can play, and three, you will be able to join me and perform a call and response and a simple melody using one of these apps. So if you haven't already, if you're just joining in, just take some time and download either the #1 Steel Pan App Gold or the Steel Pan 3D app. Okay? So let's jump right in. So the steel pan can also be called steel drum or just simply pan, which is why I'm wearing this shirt saying I love pan. And I love pan, so I wear this t-shirt. And I know by the end of this presentation, if you haven't already fallen in love with the steel pan, you too would be in love with this instrument. I see more and more people logging on. Welcome, welcome. So first thing first, I would like to tell you where this instrument is from. And does anyone know where this instrument is from? Okay, some of you know, some of you don't, and that's okay. That's why I'm here today to teach you. So this instrument is from a beautiful twin island country called Trinidad and Tobago, which is also where I am from. Now, do you know where that country is? So some of you know, some of y'all don't know, and I know we have some people who are logged on from Trinidad right now. So I'm gonna take a quick few seconds just to show you a map so you can see where that country is. Okay, so I know most of us are in America right now. So as you can see in this map, you see North America and South America. And where I am right now is in Maryland, which is on this side of North America. Now, if we go down through Central America, you get to South America. And this country here, right at the top of South America, is Venezuela. And if you look really, really, really close, you might need a magnifying glass. You would see two really tiny little islands, and those islands are Trinidad and Tobago. And that is where I am from. That is where this instrument is from. So now, I will go over a very, very basic and brief history of the sequence of events that happened to in order. This is very basic, very, 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 very basic. And for those of y'all who are joining in now, this workshop is really geared towards families who have kids, ages 4 to 8, but anyone can join, anyone can learn, and I thank you all for joining in. So if we look back here, a colleague of mine painted this beautiful mural to track the development of the events that happened in order for us to get to where this instrument is today. All the way here, you see a man playing a drum, an African drum like this. And if you logged in last week to Christoph Bacon's presentation on hip hop, he was actually playing a drum like this. So we have the African drum. And then after they were not able to play the African drum anymore, they actually started to use bamboo. So I actually have a piece of bamboo here with me today. Now bamboo is a word that begins with the letter B, B. And if you look on the vocabulary list here on the left, let me remove this yellow sheet so that you can see it. If you look on the vocabulary list here, we will have the terms that we will be describing today. So bamboo starts with the letter B, B. And what they would actually do is hit the bamboo on the street like this, and then hit the side of it with a stick. And they would create all these wonderful, wonderful, wonderful rhythms. And that is called tambu bamboo. So basically, they took the B out of bamboo and replaced it with the letter T, T. So you have tambu bamboo. Can you say tambu bamboo? Very good. So this is tambu bamboo. Then, after the people in Trinidad and Tobago were not allowed to play the tambu bamboo anymore, they started taking metal cans, metal tins, and these barrels that were made out of steel and started to make instruments out of it. And that is how we get the steel pan instrument. Now, back in the day when it first started in the 1930s, they would actually wear these instruments around their neck. And we called it pan around the neck. So they'll be wearing the instruments around their neck. And then over time, we started to put them on stands, like you see I have in the room here today. And that way, we do not hurt our necks, we don't hurt our backs for trying to carry these instruments, which can be heavy. So we have the steel pan, that started with African drum, then tambu bamboo, and then pan around the neck. So can you say that with me? African drum, tambu bamboo, pan around the neck. One more time. Very good. Wonderful. You are such a wonderful audience. So now that we know a little bit about the history of the steel pan, we are now going to start to learn about the names of some of the instruments you can find in a steel band. So a group of steel pan instruments or steel pan players playing together is called a steel band. And the first one I want to show you is this one. So just like in an orchestra where you see a violin, bass, cello, all these different instruments, the same thing in a steel band. You have different types of steel pan instruments. So this one, you only need one drum to play, and it's called a tenor. Can you see it? As you can see, it looks kind of like a turtle's shell. There are different bubbles or different dents, and each one makes a different sound.
Thank you.
So remember, this first one was called the tenor. This one over here that I have, you actually need two drums in order to make one instrument. And another word for two is double. Can you say double? So who can guess what the name of this instrument is? I'll give you a couple seconds to think. All right, so we have the tenor and we have the double tenor. So the double tenor has bigger notes, so it sounds a little bit lower than the tenor. And this song we will play, Who Let the Dogs Out, I will actually have you participate with me. And I know y'all can make some wonderful dog sounds, like dogs bark. And what we will do is something called call and response. I know you did some of this last week with Crystal's Bacon, so we're gonna do some of it again today with the steel pan. Now in the song, the singer is saying, who let the dogs out? And in response, you have to bark back at me. So if we can just get the beginning of the song so we can practice that.
Who let the dogs out?
Some golden retrievers, I want to hear some poodles, your labradors, your mixed dogs, your pothounds for those of you in Trinidad. So we're going to play Who Let the Dogs Out, and every time that part comes up, I want you to participate and bark. So here we go, I'll be playing it on the double tenor.
Who let the dogs out?
Going to play some classical music for you on the cello steel pan. by Schubert, and it is called Ave Maria. Answer them all together at the end. So we have now come into the jam. So here is when you get to play steel pan as well. So I want you to get into your steel pan app, whichever one that you're using. And in there you will see a letter. I want you to hit that letter so that you can have the notes written in on the steel pan that you're going to play. The song that we will perform today is something that all of you should be familiar with. It is Mary Had a Little Lamb. And these are actually the notes that we will use to play. So look on your steel pan in your app, and I want you to find the letter E. And I want you to play that letter E by touching it with your finger. Very good. Now I want you to find the letter D. Did you find it? Okay, now I want you to play that letter D. Good. So you have E, you have D, and you have C. Find C for me on your instrument. For those of you in the number one steel pan app, it is about 6 o'clock. All right? So now I want you to play E, D, C, D. All right, let's try it again. E, D, C, D. I went backwards. All right, so let's play it together with me. One, two, three, go. E, D, C, D. Very good. Let's try it again. One, two, ready, go. E, D, C, D. One more time. One, two, ready, go. E, D, C, D. Very good. Now, next, I want you to play three E's. Let me hear three E's from you. Good. So if you play it together, you have E, D, C, D, E, E, E. Yes, this is Mary Had a Little Lamb. And for those of you who are not able to download the app, you can still participate. All you have to do is sing the letters. So you have E, D, C, D, E, E, E. All right, so let's try it together. One, two, ready, go.
E, D, C, D, E, E, E.
Okay, so after your three E's, as you can see here, you have three D's. So we already know where D is, so let's play three D's. Good. So let's try to play these three lines. So you have E, D, C, D, E, 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 then three D's, D, D, D. Let's try. One, two, ready, go.
E, D, C, D, E, E, E.
Then three D's. Very nice. Let's try that again. One, two, ready, go.
D, C, D, E, E, E.
Then three D's. Perfect, y'all, that's so great. Moving on, we get to the purple line. Now, I know it looks like the word egg, E-G-G, but those are the notes we will play next. And if you haven't had breakfast yet, you could probably have breakfast at the end of this presentation. Have some egg. So E, G, G. So let's try to play E, G, G together. Ready, go. All right, if you haven't found G, now is the perfect time to find G. If you're on number one steel pan app, it is right next to the letter D. Let's try it again. Egg, ready, go.
E, G, G.
All right. So now let's try to play one, two, three, these four lines. If we can get these four lines, we can get the rest of the song really, really, really easily. So let's try to play all the way up to egg. So we have E, D, C, D, E, 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 then D, 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 then your egg, E, G, G. All right? So take 10 seconds to practice that. I'll give you 10 seconds. Together. So we're playing from the top all the way up to the scrambled egg. One, two, three, four.
E, D, C, D, E,
E, E. Then three D's.
D, D, D.
Then your egg.
D, G,
G. Wonderful. So we got to get to the end of this song. So we will be moving on now. So after your egg, you would notice these same two lines like what happened in the beginning. And we already know that. So we can actually play all the way up to here. Okay? So I'll give you a few seconds to practice. And if you're feeling brave enough, you can actually try to add the last line as well. It's just D, D, E, D, and then we have a C at the end. So I'll give you some time to practice, then we will play it together a couple times. Again, if you have any questions, just put it in the comment section of the video and I will answer all the questions at the end, right after we jam together. So take a few seconds, practice, I'll play it with you a couple times and then we'll get into the Q&A section. Remember, we're playing the whole thing. One, two, three, four.
E, D, C, D, E,
E,
E.
Three D's.
D, D,
D. Then the egg. G, G. Then here again.
E, D, C, D.
Three E's.
D, D, D.
And then the last line.
D, 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 C.
Let me see how many of you all made it to the end. Raise your hand if you made it to the end. Okay, some of y'all made it to the end, some didn't. So we're gonna play it again a couple more times, and I'm actually going to move over to the double tenor pan so that I can play it over there. But I want you to follow along as we go, okay? One, two, three, four.
E, D, C, D, E, E, E.
Three D's.
D, D, D.
Then the E.
G,
G.
E, D,
C, D, E,
E,
E. Then the last nine.
D, 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 D.
On the steel pan app. But if you are interested in learning how to play the steel pan, here are three websites that you can go on for some information. First one is cafeyouth.org, www.cafeyouth.org. The next one, if you want to bring steel band to your school or church, you can go on www.steelonwheels.org, which is where I got this wonderful shirt from. And then there is also my website, www.josannefrancis.com. And these websites will be added in the comment section, so you have it there in case you didn't get enough time to write it down. So, at this time, I would check my phone and look in the comment section to answer any questions that people may have had about anything that I did here today. So take some time, go in your comments, and answer and ask any questions that you may have about the instrument or about the music. So let me find going for the questions. So again, if you have any questions, put it in the comment section. I'm going to take some time and answer your questions now. Some reason I can't see all of the comments, so I'll come closer to the screen. So I'm scrolling here just to see. Well, so much for joining on. Share my contact. actually ship the instruments to the US, so you don't have to jump on a plane and go to Trinidad, even though I highly suggest that you take some time and visit Trinidad. It's a beautiful country. It's where I was born, it's where I grew up, and if you ever get the chance to travel, please, please visit Trinidad. Of course, it'll be after this global pandemic is over. But you can certainly get a steel pan in the US or in Trinidad or in many other countries as well. So I will hold up some contact information, and it will appear in the comments from Strathmore at the end as well. So you can reach out to me at management@josannefrancis.com. Pretty easy to remember. management@josannefrancis.com. Or you can email info@steelonwheels.org. Okay? So that's management@josannefrancis.com. Or you have info@steelonwheels.org. Okay. I will give you a few more seconds just to see if anyone else has any more questions. You're welcome. Thank you all for joining in today. I especially want to say a huge shout out to Strathmore for making this opportunity for musicians and presenters online, given the current global pandemic. I know a lot of musicians are out of work right now, including myself, and it's a really tough time for us, and it really warms my heart that Strathmore was still able to create this opportunity for us to connect online. So thank you to Strathmore. Someone else I want to say thank you to is my technician for today, Mr. Jonathan Castro, if you want to show your face with social distancing. All right, so Jonathan actually joined CAFE when he was how old?
6.
When he was 6 years old, and he is now 18 years old. So he stayed in CAFE for 12 years, and now he's about to graduate and go to college and study music. So this is just wonderful for all of us here at CAFE. All right, so if there are no more questions, I will actually play whatever your favorite song was, I'll play it again. So take a quick second and write your favorite song that I played here today, and I will play that song again for you. And thank you again so much for joining in. I will wait about 20 seconds. While I wait for the comments, I will go ahead and let you know there are many. If you want to check out any steel bands performing, you can go on YouTube. There are tons of videos of steel bands from all over the world performing on this beautiful instrument. And there are not only adult groups, but there are many student groups. So CAFE has many student groups. There's the Positive Vibrations Youth Steel Orchestra. There's a CAFE Rhythm Starters. So the Rhythm Starters is really for the elementary and lower middle school kids. There are bands from Trinidad, like Waiko Presbyterian. There's the Renegades Junior Steel Orchestra, All-Stars Junior Steel Orchestra. There's the Queen's Royal College Steel Band. There's many, many, many different steel bands that you can see perform that have kids in it as well. Okay, so we have a request for Who Let the Dogs Out. So I see Bri had a request, so Mary had a little lamb. Since that was just a tutorial, I'm not going to take that as a request to play, because I want us to be able to dance and really enjoy it without really trying to fuss about trying to play it. Okay, so it seems like we will have Who Let the Dogs Out. So just give me a minute, but 2 seconds to get to my instrument. I might actually have to hook up the Bluetooth again to my speaker. But if you have please put your comments, your questions. Even if I don't get to it today, I can always go back and answer your questions later, because this video will be available to you even after the live feed ends. So I'm just making sure that I'm hooked up to the music here. All right, so I will play for you now, Who Let the Dogs Out, and that will be the end. Thank you again for joining in with me today. It was certainly a pleasure playing for you and playing with you and teaching you about this instrument, this beautiful instrument that comes from my country in Trinidad and Tobago. Again, if you need more information, you can reach out to any of the resources, any of those emails, any websites that I gave you. And put your comments. If I don't get to it by the time this live feed ends, I'll come back again and answer it. Thank you again. I love you guys. Here is Who Let the Dogs Out one more time. Remember to bark like you never barked before. Wash your hands, sanitize, do all that good stuff. Bye.